question on love. Finding out your secrets.
Oh yeah, Miss Cuff. Emmerich's gonna love you.
Made by the dwarves, probably. Lovely craftsmanship. Interesting. Hello, welcome. Yes, please. Come on in. I hope you've been enjoying the Watersmeet Market so far. Good. Isn't there just so much to look at? So fascinating. All of these different fields of magic and learning, and there's just so much to see, so much to learn. Fascinating. Just truly fascinating. I'm afraid I've almost bought more than I've sold today. I can't help it. Everything is just so interesting. I've been getting a few little trinkets for my friends too, so anyway. Welcome to my little stall here. I'm selling runes, particularly runes from mind magical energy that can be used in runecasting magic. Have you ever heard of runecasting magic? No? Excellent. I was hoping you'd say that, actually. I love teaching people about the art of runecasting. So, basically, where I'm from, there are different schools of magic, but the one that I study the most is runecasting magic. And that's where you take certain little objects that are made from what we call essence, and you can form that essence into different types of runes. And each of those different types of runes represent a different type of energy in the world around us. And then you can combine those different runes with some spells and incantations and do almost anything, really. Sky's the limit. Well, not really. I mean, you have to have the right runes and you have to, you know, it takes lots of study and all that kind of stuff, but there's so much that you can do. It's really amazing. In fact, I have been studying a very special place in my world. We call it the Hollow, and it's a huge, huge reservoir of this magical essence. Unlike anything that my kind has ever found before. It's so much energy, and we've been creating new, different kinds of runes that no one had even heard about before that we're getting from this amazing energy. It's so fascinating. There's so much to learn, so much to study. I could study my whole life and still probably only scratch the surface. But anyway, yeah, feel free to look around. Yeah, would you like me to show you some of the different types of runes that I have here? Sure, yes, I would be more than happy to. Here, let's start with these. Now, as you can see, all of these are the different types of runes that I have. Once you refine them, they make into these cute little cubes that have different symbols on each of them. But when you first mine the energy, it comes out like this, in these almost gemstone-looking crystals. Beautiful forms. So you can see the vibrancy of the colors, all different types of colors. So this, through a magical process of mining, is what we extract from a source of essence. And then we have a refining process that creates the different types of runes from these different chunks of energy. So first we have our basic elemental runes, air runes, these lovely little white ones. And then we have earth, of course. You can see all those different symbols on there. Water runes as well. And then back here we have some fire runes. Fascinating what you can do with even just the most basic elemental runes. They all obviously have the power of their different elements, but they also stand for different things. For example, water is a very fluid element, and so oftentimes it's used in spells that help change the form of something. Air is a very freeing element, and so sometimes it's used in spells to help release something, unbinding spells, that kind of stuff. Whereas earth is very solid. You know, you get the idea. So those are our four elemental runes, but then we also have nature runes here, these lovely green ones. Now these runes are, yes, they connect to the nature that's all around us, but they also can tap into the nature of a thing, the nature of a person, the aspects of something that makes it what it is. And so nature runes can be used to change that nature, as well as to sort of help someone remember who they are, if a spell is a transforming spell. Then we also have these lovely little purple ones. These are celestial runes. Now these are runes that connect you to the power of the stars. These are mostly only used for second level spells and above, but there are a few basic beginner spells. And then we have these lovely silver runes. These are healing runes. So obviously they're used for healing physically, but also healing things like a broken heart or a strained relationship. It's a rune of harmony. You can interpret that however you like. Then we do have a few rarer runes here that are actually a bit dangerous. So I haven't actually sold any of these today. I'm a bit uncomfortable with them, selling them to people who have never heard about runecasting magic before, but I do like to show them just so you can see sort of the vast possibilities that you can do with runecasting magic. So these in here are called shadow runes. And shadow runes, while they obviously are the element of darkness, they're also the element of mystery, of change, of all kinds of things. And they can be used in very negative ways, but they can also be used in positive healing spells as well. Or sometimes if you need to reveal something in the darkness, you can use a shadow rune. There can't be light without dark. So just like in nature, there is balance in runes. And then that brings me to our last kind here. Now these are a fascinating, fascinating rune with quite a lot of power. So these I definitely would not sell to anyone who didn't really know what they were doing. But these are chaos runes. Now I know chaos sort of gets a bad rap in nature. It's never generally seen as sort of a negative thing, but chaos is, it's just the opposite of order. And in nature, there is a balance. There is order and there is chaos. There is life and there is death. So, someone who has studied the balance of life, the balance of nature, and understands that, can use these for, well, good or ill, I suppose. But those are not used until quite, quite advanced spells, because obviously they can be quite, well, chaotic. But I do like to show people the different possibilities. Now I also, of course, have some spell books here as well that could get you started on basic spells. This is a beginner's book of spells. Anything from different household tasks that you'd like completed to basic manipulation of the elements, as well as some simple combat spells as well, like a low-level air blast and things like that are all in this book here. So there really is endless possibilities when it comes to runecasting magic. So there you have it. There's my basic sort of arrangement of the runes that I've brought today. Now, for the Watersmeet Market, if you're interested, I am running sort of a beginner rune casting special today. You'll get the book of beginning spells, and then you'll also get a lovely array of all of the different elemental runes. So you'll get air and fire and earth and nature and water and a few celestial runes. So basically everything that you need to get started on some basic spells. And all of that would be together 10 gold, which is quite a discount of what I normally sell them for. Yeah? Wonderful. Sure, let me get that package up for you, okay? Should be everything that you need to get started with some wonderful spells of your own. Oh, and here's the book over here for you. So, those two together will be 10 gold, please. Oh, I'm sorry, what sort of currency do you have with you? Oh, I've never heard of that before. You know what, hold on, they gave me a conversion chart somewhere. They were handing these out to the vendors. Definitely come in handy today. Here we go. Okay, what were they called? All right. Ah, there they are. Okay, so it looks like 10 gold is the equivalent of 2 Gorgonian death emblems. All right. Wonderful. Fascinating. Well, thank you very much. Here you are, your new spellbook and lovely runes there. Yeah, you enjoy. I hope that you have some fun learning about rune crafting. And of course, seeing all of the other stalls and all the other different types of magic here. It's definitely an experience to remember, that's for sure. All right, well, if you decide that you'd like to pick up any more runes, you know where to find me. Otherwise, enjoy the rest of the Watersmeet Market.